Okay, now there's two more things that we have to make. We have to make our sushi rice, and we have to make our wasabi. So we'll make our wasabi first. First thing we need to do is open the tin of wasabi powder. This stuff is firecrackers in a jar, in a can. Okay, so you just need a little tablespoon of that, kind of a light green color. You add a little water to it. Mix it up, and it starts to turn into the green color that we're all familiar with this wasabi. Looks a little wet right now, but it'll thicken up in a few minutes. And if it had smell-o-vision, you could smell the horseradish from over there. All right, so that's basically done. Put that away. Put the water away. Now what we're going to do is we're going to make our sushi rice. Sushi rice is now cooked and it's very hot. So what we're going to do is we're going to put it out on this cleaned surface here. What we're going to do is we're going to take our rice. Lay it out on this. Need a kind of a big surface to put it out on here because we want to cool the rice right now. Right now we want to cool the rice off and stop it from cooking. And as it's cooling and evaporating, we want to add some of our sushi stew over it. Just drip it over like this. Here and there and everywhere, a little bit here, a little bit there, not too much. You don't want it to get too soaky. Then mix it around a little bit. It's a very pungent smell coming off that. The vinegar is evaporating. Okay, mix it around a little bit like this. And what we're going to do now is we're going to take our fan it a little bit. Fan it a little bit, cool it off a little more. We want it actually to be evaporated a little bit so it goes back to being sticky again. So after this is all cooled off and evaporated, it'll be ready to make into sushi. Okay, now what we're going to do is we're just going to take all our sushi here, put it into a bowl. All right. We're going to set it in the fridge to chill for about a half an hour.